I'm very pleased to be able to speak with Mr. Deepak Parekh, one of the founding members of HDFC, a housing mortgage conglomerate in India and a leader in the financial services industry in this country. Thank you very much for speaking with us. How many years would you say you've been in the industry called the financial services industry?
Oh, now it is about 40.
And before HDFC, what were you doing?
Before HDFC, I was with Chase Manhattan Bank. And before that, I was for 3 years in National Grindlays Bank.
And you're seen as one of the most important pioneers in making housing finance available to the masses in India. And you've led the HDFC group from strength to strength since 19... Well, you've been involved in the group since
1973.
33 years. Where is housing finance today in India, and what is the work that remains to be done?
Oh, we have just scratched the surface in India so far as mortgage finance is concerned. Although we started 33 years ago, housing as a percentage of GDP in India is only 7 to 8%. In Singapore it is 60%. In Europe, in some of the European countries, 80% and 90%. In the US, even Thailand is 20%, while in India it is still 8%. So we have a long way to go to be able to help Indians own their own home in which they stay.
HDFC, in over 30 years, has about 3.5 million customers, basically. Could it not have been scaled up much faster than that?
Well, we are dealing with cash. Cash is a raw material. Processes in India are, you know, the country is very large. Each state has different rules on land and other legal issues. We have to build up expertise. All these years, we've grown at 25 to 30% on an annual basis, on a denominator that is becoming larger and larger. So more than a 25 to 30% growth, it is humanly not possible. The amount of paperwork we have to deal with, the number of clients we have to meet. And so, you know, it is very difficult. A financial company, according to me, cannot double and triple their operations on an annual basis. It will start hurting afterwards. The quality will suffer, the non-performing loans will mount, the caliber of people will deteriorate because you'll hire anyone who comes down because you have so much urgent need. So you have to have a calibrated growth in financial sector if you want a clean, good, strong balance sheet.
The track record of HDFC is outstanding. It's perhaps one of the most successful housing finance corporations in the world. You have the lowest, among the lowest NPLs, strong profitability, but sustainable growth, as you've mentioned. Are you today at an inflection point of some kind, given where India, the country, is at the moment? Do you think that plans have to be put in place if the government were to liberalize home ownership, make it easier and so on?
No, the scope in this business is huge. So I don't think we have, as I said, we've just scratched the surface. There's a whole lot of growth. Boston Consulting did a survey recently where they said the outstanding mortgages today in India are 5 trillion rupees. And they say in 2020, this will be 40 trillion rupees. 40 trillion rupees, that means an 8-time growth in mortgages in 10 years. So scope for our business is very good. We are not worried about the demand side. The concern is on the liability side, whether we will be able to get that many funding from different agencies, from our bond issues, from commercial banks, from insurance companies. The point you are asking about this inflection point is what the government needs to do is to release more land for construction. Today there's a shortage of, it takes a long time for the state government to give approvals to start a building project. There are multiplicity of approvals you need before any developer can start a housing project. We need to compress that time so that more stock comes into the market more regularly rather than the process is very slow. The municipal approvals, because there are some 46 approvals we need from the water, sewage, civil aviation, fire, police, all kinds of things.
Right. Given your status in the industry and your achievement in having built HDFC as you have, to what extent are you able to influence that part of the process, government?
Well, I'm on a number of advisory boards with the government. I've chaired a number of committees, but you know, land is a state subject. It's not a central subject. So any committee the central government sets up, the government sets up, the center can only recommend to the states. The states have to implement them. And this is where the problem comes. The center can direct the state, but the action at the state level is slow.
What are your most important concerns about India as it's progressing, at least financially? It's got a lot more resources than it ever had in its history as an independent
country. No, we have number of issues, worries. Infrastructure is a big concern. Infrastructure slows down growth, lack of infrastructure. Again, we talked about land. 70% of all infrastructure projects get delayed or derailed because of land acquisition. Land acquisition is a very archaic process in India. Land laws are archaic. And acquisition of agricultural land and converting agricultural land into residential, industrial, commercial is a very time-consuming, lengthy, uncertain affair. So, you know, infrastructure development is India's weakness. Today, everyone talks about lack of infrastructure. But because it's a weakness, it's an opportunity for investment.
See a light at the end of the tunnel?
Yes. You see our telecom system today. Our telecom system is one of the cheapest in the world. And we are selling 20 million mobile units, hand units per month. And the tele density has now gone up to 65% from 10% in a matter of 7, 8, 10 years. So there is a huge achievement in the telecom sector. Similarly, four private sector airports have been built, or the last one is under final construction, Bombay. But Delhi, Bangalore, Hyderabad are state-of-the-art airports. And if Bombay is completed in the next few months, by the end of this year, we will have about 80% of the traffic coming in and going out at the best airports. Similarly, there are a large number of ports which are under construction. Some have been completed, state-of-the-art ports. Some there is work in progress. There's a massive road construction program going on in India and the national highways connecting state capitals and North-South-East Expressway, North-South-East-West Expressway. So, you know, there's a lot of money being spent on infrastructure. So, but at the moment, we still lag in our infrastructure. And if proper infrastructure is there, we could get into a double-digit GDP growth also.